Hey guys, this is Red and welcome back to a new Minecraft video. Today we have other command blocks behind me. Look at that line, how big it is. So as you saw from the title of this video guys, this is the first episode of a new series that I wanted to bring on this channel, which is called Minecraft Mini Blocks. So the aim of this series is that I pick some different Minecraft blocks. For example, here we have a crafting table, a door and a note block. And all I have to do is to recreate these blocks with the same functionalities that they have, but in a miniature version using, of course, command blocks. Now, this is something like Seth Bling's Mega Blocks series, but the opposite, okay? Instead, we have to recreate mini blocks. So, let's start. I have here a crafting table, so I think that you guys already know what a crafting table does. And I have here some crafting recipes that I wanna use on this new mini crafting table. And let's say that I want to craft a sword. Now, an iron sword is made out of 2 iron ingots and a stick. So, let's drop down 2 iron ingots and a stick on the crafting table. And as you can see, we got a sword. But what happens if I try to drop the same exact items not on the crafting table? So let's take these and 2 iron ingots. So if I try to drop them here, 2 and 1, you can see that nothing happens. So these crafting recipes only work, oh yeah, they united together with this one, they only work on this crafting table. And I also made another example. For example, a bow is made out of 3 sticks and 3 strings. So let's drop the strings and the sticks and boom, we have a bow. Alright, so that was the crafting table. Let's carry on with the next Minecraft blocks. Then of course guys, I will leave all the commands that I use in this video in the video description. There's a link, if you click it, you'll be forwarded to my webpage. And on my webpage, I will leave all these commands so you can take a look and see how I did this. And after I finish to showcase these 3 items, I'm going to go really quickly through these commands and explain them in a quick and easy way. So, doors. Doors are simple blocks where players can interact. So you can see that if I right click on a door, it opens and closes, and also it generates this opening closing sound. I have here a miniature door, and guess what? It does the same exact thing. So I am currently right clicking with my mouse, and the door is, this miniature door is opening, closing, opening and closes, closing, opening and closing. And also it has a better animation, because for example, normal doors, if you right click them, they go straight from open to close. Instead, this one, it has a transitioning animation. So you can see that it opens and it closes. It's a bit glitched out when I close it sometimes. Oh, no, not. You can see that it's really, really smooth. And it has this opening and closing animation. And of course, you can hear the opening and closing sounds. The third block of this episode is a note block. And this is the block that, look at how many command blocks I need to set up. This is because I had to set up all of the different sounds played by the note block. So, a note block, how does it work? Well, you can right-click on it and it will generate a sound. Every time that you right-click, the pitch will change and will become higher. But one other feature of these blocks is that we can place different types of blocks under them to change the type of sound that is played. So, if we place sand instead of dirt under it, you can see that it has a different sound played. Well, okay, let me show guys how it sounds with dirt. You have the normal piano sound, okay? Under this small one, we have a block of dirt as well, so let's try it. You can see that it works exactly the same, so these particles, note particles are generated, the sounds are played. Okay, I'm not gonna talk so you can hear it, and yeah. All I have to do is to right-click exactly on the hitbox of this micro-block here and stay close to it. Right, so now let's see what happens when we change it to sand. So, again, this is how it sounds like with sand. Let's place a block of sand here. Set block sand. Alright, so we place the block of sand. And, okay, let's hear again how it sounds like. Let's try to use it. And it does the same exact thing. So you can see that it works again, and if I try to change it back to dirt, it will play the piano sound. Simple as that. So that was it about this block as well. This is what requested me most of the time to set up, because I had to set up all of the different sounds and the pitches of the sound. And right now, let me guys explain you in a really quick way. I'm not going to go through all of the commands. I'm just going to explain in a quick way how I recreated them. So of course there are some invisible armor stands here. And why am I lagging so much when I go in game mode 3? I think that there are some entities in my world that are causing this. Anyways, there are some invisible armor stands that are wearing a block, and the reason why I am placing them on a slab is that because I placed a glowstone block under them. Because basically, if you place armor stands, invisible armor stands under the ground in Minecraft, this is what happens. The texture will become really, really dark. And one way to solve it is to place, of course, a luminescent block exactly in the hitbox of the armor stand, so it illuminates back. So that's why I just wanted to hide the glowstone block. So here we have an invisible armor stand that is wearing a crafting bench on the head. But everything is inside these commands, so here I just use a normal ground crafting command. So what I did, I give some different scores to the items that I drop on the ground, and every time that two of these items are found, other commands are going to summon the, for example, the iron sword item or the bow item, and then is going to kill the items that I use to craft that recipe. And that's it. So for the door, I have used again an invisible armor stand wearing a door. But now we have also an invisible villager, which is called Doorville, which stands for villager door or something like this. So every time that a player right clicks, basically other commands are going to detect, it's basically a right click detection. So the commands are going to detect when I right click. And when a player right clicks, basically other commands are going to rotate the armor stand. Now, one thing is that if we just rotate the head of the armor stand, the door will not look exactly in the same place. For example, it will be offset by 0.3 blocks or something like this. So it will look open, but not exactly here. It will look open like here. So another thing that I had to do is that I had to teleport the armor stand when basically I open or close the door. So the armor stand, it teleported 0.3 blocks and then minus 0.3 blocks, so it goes back to its place. Something like that. And again, I use some slash play sound commands to generate the sound. Now, for this one is really simple. Again, we have an invisible armor stand and an invisible villager, which is called Noteville, villager note block, basically. And every time that I right click on this villager, he will get a different score on a scoreboard that I have created. So every time that I right click, that score increases. So it goes to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, to 25. 25 is the last score. And every time that villager has a different score, for example, if it has a score of 4, a sound will be played, so the block.note.harp sound will be played with a custom pitch. So for example, here we have 0.6, this is the pitch, 0.63, and you see that it goes higher and higher, which will represent the note sound having a higher pitch, 0.75, 0.8. Now, how did I detect for the different blocks? It's simple. So, you know, in commands, you can use a simple execute detect command. So I have executed for the villager, and relative to it, I have detected whether it has a dirt block under it, or a sand block. So here there should be the detect sand. You can see sand. So depending on which block it has, which block is detected, we are going to generate different sounds. So here we have the block.note.harp, but when a sand block is detected, we have a different play sound. We have a block.note.snare sound, of course, with all of the different pitches. Now, I made it work only for the dirt and the sand, but of course, there is another sound with if you place a piece of wood under the note block and if you place other types of blocks. But I didn't want to add them because look at how many command blocks it needs to set up all of the sounds. So that was pretty much it about today's episode of Mini Blocks. If you want, if you have a specific block that you love, like in Minecraft, just suggest me in the comment section down below, and the most voted blocks, the most, like, just write them in the comment section down below, and the blocks that I see that are most requested, I will recreate them in a miniature version in a next episode of Mini Blocks in Minecraft. So guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did so, don't forget to drop a like under it. That would be highly, highly, highly appreciated, guys. Your support, especially now, is a lot needed on the channel, because you probably may have seen that my videos are not getting that much attention that they were getting some time ago. I don't know, it's a problem with YouTube, because this has happened Suddenly, it happened suddenly this month, I had a big drop in views, I don't know why. Also, my graphs, they were really strange. I had like negative views on the real-time graphs. I also tweeted this to YouTube, but I didn't respond. So I really don't know what to do, guys. And the only help I can get is from you. By leaving a like, maybe the video will go in the algorithm, which was screwed up lately, and it will gain some attention. But anyways, guys, I want to thank you all for watching this video until the end. And I guess that I'll see you in the next one. See you. Bye.